That's what I'm talking about.
Wait.
Okay, now, from the beginning.
Hit it, boys.
Informing and entertaining you to the best of our ability for your Remembrance Day 2022. This is Anthony on War. Join Chrono Corner where the big boys play. From Black Dominion Media.
Hey, it's Anthony here on your Remembrance Day, and so why are we here? Now, Webster's Dictionary defines war as a state of usually open and declared armed hostile conflict between states or nations. Now, war is characterized by extreme violence, social disruption, and economic destruction. But you see, war should be understood as an actual international and widespread conflict between political communities, and therefore should be defined as a form of political abuse or violence, no? Now, unfortunately, over the clutches of time, we've seen several different types of war. We've seen the Cold Wars, Colonial Wars, Insurgency Wars, Wars of Independence, Wars of Liberation, Fault Line War, Invasion Wars, Proxy Wars, Range Wars, Religious Wars, Undeclared Wars, Total War, Limited War, World War, and one of the worst ones of all, Civil War. Now, unfortunately, there's far too many historical conflicts to go through. But just as a prime example, by the death toll, the numbers, World War II brought us 70 million losses, the Mongolian conquest, 30 million, the Taiping Rebellion, 20 million, and the European colonization on the Americas, 8.5 million. Now, when we look at just that, which is a mere pittance drop, that's over 150 million that gave the ultimate sacrifice. Now, if we had time to add them all up, surely the figurative equation would come out to shine light on what has to have been historically the real threat to man, and that's war itself. So, we look at this, we read these numbers, and we think, well, why the fuck does this even happen in the first place? Well, you see, there's rarely one single clear cause of conflict. Now, the cause of all these wars are usually numerous and can often be intertwined in a very complicated way. Historically, most wars have been through economic gain, territorial gain, religion, nationalism, revenge, civil war, revolutionary war, defensive war. Now, we sit and look at all these in a modern-day society and think, what a load of bullshit. But you had to be there. Now, I tried my hardest to come up through my research to find some good notes on anything that good that's become of war, and basically I kept on falling on the same sheets and notes, and they were diaries of madmen. You see, studies have shown that conflict situations cause more mortality and disability than any other major disease. Now, war itself, it destroys communities and families and often disrupts the development of social and economical fabric of nations, like the long-term physical and psychological harm to children and adults. But getting us to the inevitable, the one that takes the men and women into service that give the ultimate sacrifice, death. Now, in today's modern world, unfortunately, there are some of us from different countries that have active wars and conflict from wherever their native land is. But for the most part, we're all pretty much a generation or two separated from the clutches of any wars, to say the least, right? And let's face it, a lot of that is due to the direct result of the sacrifices that the ones before us had actually made. Now, it's extremely easy for the generations of today to speak in retrospect through the eyes of hindsight by saying that it was all completely wrong and all the wars were unnecessary. Or because maybe possibly we've progressed as nations with regards to education and communication and whatnot. And also the mere fact that, well, we've never fell witness or had to undergo any of the act of being forced with the moral and ethical choices of having to encounter the likes of these kind of things during these times, which were risks to sure probably like living in hell, right? Now, myself, being a Scottish expat in the UK, both of my grandfathers served against the Nazi regime in the Second World War. Now, my grandfather, Tim Donnelly, he fought in the water, serving the British Navy. My grandfather, Peter Dunnigan, took them by land, serving in Her Majesty's Army. Now, I do understand when generations of today find these historical conflicts repulsive or unnecessary. But through having known what I know, by having both grandfathers that served to return home and return home alive, having the luxury of trying to deal with morality and ethics were certainly not on the table and definitely not an option. Now, I lost my grandfather, Tim Donnelly, when I was at a very young age. It was premature to a heart attack. But the strength of his heart was certainly not a question after serving and sacrificing what he must have had to have went through. So unfortunately, I never really got a chance or remember too much any of his memories in service. But undoubtedly, they're a mirror image to my grandfather, Peter's. Now, I would sit up to the wee hours in the morning with my grandfather, Peter, at times, listening to stories that would make the modern film look like something from Disneyland. You see, the modern film can only biopic and give you a three-dimensional glimpse of what things look like or how it was, right? But I'm speaking of something different. I'm speaking of the emotions, the empathy, and the tears from a loved one that lost and gave so much. You see, he was one of many brothers. Not all those brothers made it home. Now, I can remember from time to time him showing me the actual letters and holding them in my hands and reading them. And these were the letters that came through his mother's door to inform her and the rest of our family that their sons, his brothers, had been missing and presumed dead and had fought and done his best. And that's it. One paragraph. Now, the stories that I had heard from this man that he had to go through, just like the rest of the good men and women that served, were not only reality, but to us are tales of horror like anything you could possibly imagine. I remember one night on an occasion I asked him what was the worst he'd ever experienced in the battlefield against the enemy. Now usually it'd be me and him up extremely late in a tenement house living room with nothing but the fire on, the lights out, the whiskey out, and the tears certainly falling. But on this occasion, the tears fell much more than the other ones did. Now he had went on to sharing with me a story about the horror and the wrongdoing of what Adolf Hitler had forced upon his own, and that was forming the Hitler Youth. Now the Hitler Youth was an organization of the Nazi Party in Germany. Now the members of the Hitler Youth were viewed as ensuring the future of Nazi Germany, and they were indoctrinated into the Nazi ideology, including racism. Now the Nazi leaders had began turning the Hitler Youth into a military reserve to replace the manpower, which was definitely depleting at the time. There were over 20,000 German youths deployed against the British and the Canadian at the attempt to repulse the D-Day invasion. Now, while they knocked out 20 Canadian tanks during their first effort, they ultimately lost 3,000 lives before the Normandy assault was complete. Now, unfortunately, they were starting to get recruited at ever young ages, commonly drafting a 12-year-old Hitler Youth member into its ranks. Now, I can remember my dear grandfather breaking his heart and telling me that we were all young men out there as allies, fighting this fucking battle, and how disgusting it was that a man was sending innocent young boys into fight a man's war. Now this, I dare say, has to be one tale that really had a psychological deep-rooted scar. And it's a scar of torment, a scar of regret, and a scar of repulse. I mean, one only has to imagine the tales that I heard being left at the other end of a rifle facing a shivering child that unfortunately you have to go through and bury with your own hands. And it's all in the act of war. Now, his story is not unique. There are literally millions of other brave men and women with similar stories. Stories of what their wartime experience was like that I can guarantee you are probably the likes of tales that are simply unimaginable. Now, these were all, for the most part, even some on the other side, the enemy, common, innocent people with loving families who had, for a brief chapter in their lives, been interrupted. Now, they were left with only two options. They either had to face the enemy or succumb to becoming the Mussolinis of the day, bend over and become Hitler's lapdog and form alliance with the Nazi regime, or simply stand up and fight and serve like those brave men and women did. Now, be it the Second World War, any civil war, political war, racial war that's played out historically through our darkest chapters and our darkest hours, we don't actually praise or promote or approve any of the actual war itself. We pay respect and praise all of the innocent men and women and children that gave service and fought for the cause in the front lines or served as support in the home front. And we also unconditionally honor the ones that gave the ultimate sacrifice. So it is today, Remembrance Day, we show our respect to them in knowing that we will always remember. Now, in the words of a man that led an attack in World War I that failed miserably, Mr. Winston Churchill once said, "It is of those who fail to learn from history are doomed to repeat it." And from the mind of one of the world's greatest minds of all time, German-born theoretical physicist Albert Einstein once said, "The world will not be destroyed by those who do evil, but by those who watch them without doing anything." Thank you for your time, and always remember. On a simple line, day by day, the earth spins on its axis. One man's trouble, while another relaxes.
For your Remembrance Day, sending you the best of juju, love, luck, and health, in wishing you and yours good night. And to always remember, as lest we forget. Black Donnelly Media.